Guys, Apple just released the iOS 26 public update, and it is packed full of features that will actually change how you use your iPhone every day. From a delightful redesign that's instantly familiar to making your favorite apps feel effortlessly helpful, this update makes iOS 18 feel like a distant memory. Now, iOS 26 is more useful, it is more personal, and it's more fluid than what came before it. Here are five things that you are going to notice right away and why they actually matter. Let's get started. By far the biggest change coming in iOS 26 and across all of your Apple devices this year is the brand new design language called Liquid Glass. Liquid Glass makes the entire experience feel lighter, softer, and more fluid. It acts like real glass, shifting, layering, and reflecting all the elements below it just enough so it feels alive. But iOS 26 goes well beyond just the surface of what you see. Apple's brought the redesign to all the apps, but Safari, Phone, and Music by far are their most standout, exceptional examples. Now, inside the Phone app, you're gonna get a clean cart-style interface, which separates your contacts from recents into different layered sections. It's just very easy to use, and it looks very pleasant. Now, Safari stretches edge to edge with this floating tab bar at the very bottom, which just kind of effortlessly disappears when you scroll. Then there's the Music app, which brings back full screen artwork, blending it into the background controls with a soft blur and depth, which is just really second to none in my opinion. Now, it's not just about how your iPhone looks, but it's more about how it feels. And because this design carries across all of your devices, everything you now use speaks the same visual language. Now, as part of the Liquid Glass redesign, both the look and feel of your iPhone is taking a giant leap forward. And that point is evident on your home screen, lock screen, and the app icons. First, let's take a look at the lock screen. Now, there's a brand new dynamic clock that can be resized to better match your wallpaper. And if you're someone like me who uses lock screen widgets, the widgets are going to shift to the bottom, improving the reachability, especially if you have a larger Pro Max device. Second, you can now turn 2D images into spatial scenes that give your wallpaper an added depth and dimension that really just kind of makes it feel alive. This would look really, really good on the Home Hub. Let's wait to see if that comes out in the fall. Now let's switch over to the home screen. We've got added looks for your app icons, including clear light, clear dark, and improved app tinting, which looks fantastic. Home screen widgets now have a glass-like edge around the top and bottom, so you can easily see them on your home screen. Now, the clear app icons are certainly flatter, but I'm really loving the clear dark app icons. If you're on the beta, let me know if you are on team light, team dark down in the comments below. But most importantly, the entire interface responds with subtle pops of animation, like when you pull down on the lock screen or the notification shade, and it looks like the shade itself is actually like it's refracting light. It looks beautiful. Or when you open up the control center and there's this cool popover animation when you want to connect to a Wi-Fi network, and it all comes together in a way that just makes your iPhone fun to use again. Apple just did not redesign the look, they redesigned the entire vibe. Now, if you just installed iOS 26 beta and you want to steal my exact setup from the lock screen themes to the home screen icons and the features I always enable first, I put together a free iOS 26 starter guide. It's linked down below, totally free, and it'll help you set up things the smart way. Next up is number three, and it's honestly my second most used app. It is camera. Now, I'm always taking pictures of my son who loves doing goofy things or the latest gadget that I have on my desk. Well, the camera app in iOS 26 finally gets the redesign that we've all been waiting for. It's got a cleaner layout, better spacing, and it's just a smarter way for you interacting with the tools and controls that you use the most inside the camera app. Now, when you first open up the camera app, only the photo and video tabs are available or are visible. If you want to, you can drag right or left to bring up the other modes, but they stay tucked away by default, which helps reduce visual clutter. Now, switching between the camera modes is simpler than ever. All you do is drag your finger left or right on the modes so they can be revealed, and a double tap on that mode will reveal the additional controls, making them easy to tap and configure. Now, once you're done shooting, you can tap on the preview in the bottom left-hand corner. It's now a round preview instead of a square preview, taking you into the photo app itself. Now, Photos actually has been redesigned as well. It's got a new two-panel layout that seems to fix what Apple shipped last year. They kind of screwed up everyone's photos. A lot of people are mad. And if that's you, let me know down in the comments below. But you've got a cleaner library view on one side and collections on the other, which is a better job, in my opinion, of reorganizing memories and screenshots without burying them in the clutter. It's not a dynamic overhaul, but it's a clear step in the right direction. Now, again, if you are one of those people where Apple borked your photos in iOS 18, this should be a welcome change for you. Number four, hands down, is my most used app. For me, it's gonna be the Messages app, and for you, I bet it is the same. The updates coming in iOS 26 are those rare things when you look at it and everything kind of feels super obvious where you thought to yourself, why didn't this exist earlier? I mean, why are we waiting so long to get this? Well, first thing that you'll notice is that you can now have different chat backgrounds. Either party can assign a different background, and if you don't want to see the background, you can turn that off. The backgrounds can be created either in image playgrounds, selecting a photo from photos, or one of several different themes, including sky and ocean. Now, if you look very carefully, there are several color themes, and it seems a little weird that Apple included 12. They've got some nice colors like stone, ice, carbon. They might sound like iPhone colors, but you let me know what you think. I wouldn't be too mad if Apple actually released these colors. Now, these chat backgrounds, they move, they react, they add color and personality to every conversation, especially in group chats where they can be applied as well. Now, speaking of group chats, you can now create polls right inside of messages. There's no more third-party apps, no more links, just a built-in feature that works exactly how you would expect. And participants can even write in their own option. This is great for picking dinner spots, coordinating plans, or just arguing which of your favorite football teams are going to win the Europa Cup next year. Now, Apple Pay is also available for groups, which lets you split costs or spend money. Super useful for group gifts or shared expenses, or that concert ticket that you forgot to pay your friend back for. Now, of course, there are typing indicators that are across the board in group chats as well, and you can actually see who's about to respond in real time. Now, for number 5, we're gonna stay in messages because this is where your iPhone starts to feel like it's genuinely aware of what is going on. Hello, Hal.
Affirmative, Dave.
Apple is bringing that big feature energy, and it shows up in new powerful ways right inside of your iPhone. First, messages and FaceTime are getting real-time translation. You can send and receive messages in one language and have it translated instantly into another, and you can even have it read out loud to the other person. Then inside of the phone app, there's call screening. Your iPhone will answer unknown calls on your behalf and give you a live transcript of what the other person is saying. I don't need Google Assistant anymore, see you later. You can decide whether you want to pick it up, ignore it, or let the assistant handle the call completely. Now there's also Hold Assist, which automatically waits on hold for you and lets you know the moment that there is a real human when you pick up. Maybe you have to call your carrier, you gotta call Verizon, Comcast. Who knows, you don't wanna wait on hold because it's one of the worst things ever. There are no flashy AI demos, they're just smart and practical. And yes, this is all powered by Apple Intelligence, but it doesn't feel like a prompt or a pop-up. It just quietly makes your iPhone better. Now, looking back, iOS 18 was functional, but iOS 26 feels intentional. It's not just a collection of features kind of hodgepodgely put together. It feels like a full system upgrade that's been designed to make your iPhone feel alive again. It is thoughtful, it is fluid, and it's got personality. Now, there's more under the hood like Journal, new accessibility tools, smarter AirPod controls, which I can't wait to show you, and even more Apple Intelligence features. But these are the five that you are gonna notice first, the ones that you are actually gonna use, and the ones that make iOS 26 feel like a real leap forward, people. Now, if you wanna see all my favorite changes for iPad 26, iPadOS 26, you can click on this video right here. Otherwise, I've got deep dives coming on iOS 26, Apple Intelligence, and everything else that you need to know about it. So hit subscribe, turn on notifications, and I'll catch you in the next one.